Alright, welcome to my video of Megaman X3. So this is my opening here for my PlayStation 3. You get to see my Hyperdimension Neptunia theme. And this is the point where I get to start explaining how my capture card doesn't like how much this thing changes resolution here. This is the Megaman X Collection on the PlayStation 2, running on my PlayStation 3. And the way that this specific version of Megaman X3 works is that it's not the Super Nintendo version that most people in America are familiar with. It's the port that was done to the PlayStation and Sega Saturn. So it's got a bunch of these cutscenes that change resolution as it goes through. Real pain in the butt for my video card to try and deal with. So I've had a couple of these videos together, had to do a couple of things over again. But yeah, all 2.5 hours of this all the way through is a pretty good walkthrough about how to beat Mega Man X3 and get all the stuff. So yeah, here's the opening cutscene here. It would normally have some great Japanese music, but it's been localized. When consoles started using optical media, they started licensing music so that the music itself could actually play off the disc, which they had the space to do now. So they would license tracks from artists, in Japan especially, and they would get great pop music, but we would lose all that in America because of the licensing agreements and whatnot. They didn't want to shell out the money to get the original Japanese audio. But yeah, what you're seeing here is an animated cutscene with various stuff from the first three Mega Man games. That was from X1. This right here is from the Flame Stag stage in X2. That's the logo of Sigma with the three bosses from X2 that have Zero's parts. Vile, who was supposed to be dead in X1, spoilers, he's alive in this one. Zero saved the day with his golden locks. Yeah, buddy. Okay, so as he dashes under the door here, this is his armor from X1. You'll notice that's Zero's Buster on his hand there. And then this is Sigma's form from X1. And then as he changes into his X2 form here, Sigma changes into his X2 form. Everybody had the Wolverine claws in the 90s. And then this is Dr. Doppler from this game, with all the bosses. Alright, so the first thing you always want to do with these Mega Man X games is switch the dash to the trigger. It allows you to charge and dash and do different things. It's just easier to have it there. Yeah, this is an interesting little cutscene. It cuts right in from animation into game graphics from Zero scouting ahead, as he always does. Oh, Okay, so for you unfamiliar with the process of capturing here and HDMI in general, there's a lot of lag because of the way things render digitally, and especially with games as brutal as the Mega Man series, the lag can kill you. So this has taken me a lot of trial and error to figure out how many different settings I can set up and plug it through the splitter so that it goes to my computer and the monitoring television. It's been a nightmare, and there's still some lag, so the run here is not perfect, but it's good enough for a video. Alright, so the main character has been captured. Time for Zero to step in. Alright, and what you're going to see here is with the green charge, he gets two shots, and then his saber. And yes, by the end of the game, we're going to get X to wield Zero's saber here, and go back and do all the bosses with Zero's saber, because it's just so much fun to do. Yeah, it takes down like half their HP with one shot. With mini bosses here, it takes down all of their HP except for one. So you'll see me hit them with the saber and then blast them with something a little extra anytime I come up against a mini boss with the saber. So yeah, there you see me charging it up so I can dash right in and use it. Yep, just one little extra hit. Now I gotta get Mega Man down. So I'm gonna do it with style. Yeah, the boss is bigger and tougher than he is. Less tough than he looks. Looks tougher than you? Whatever. Yeah, he's gonna die pretty quickly here. So yeah, you can actually use Zero for parts of this game. I never do unless it's in the course of getting his Z-saber, as you'll see later on. Alright, so you want to start out with Blizzard Buffalo and the Tunnel Rhino so that you can use their weapons should you happen to come across Bit and Byte. Destroying them is essential for, I think, the gold armor and not Zero's saber. I think Zero's saber will with crab leg. Yeah, you really gotta be careful as you're sliding around on the ice here. It can knock you into some nasty spikes or enemies. Just be real careful with it. I like saving this life pellet there for later, because as you can see, when you come back, you're probably going to need it with all the energies you take damage from. That jump is really difficult, and you gotta be careful not to get caught with that guy's ice stuff down where he can't hit you, because the game can get stuck in an infinite loop where it's just hitting you with that ice and sticking you in the spot, and you just can't move. It'll just keep shooting you. Alright, so this is the first piece of armor, the leg armor. Now, there are two pieces of armor for every slot in this game, but if you pick them up in the capsules in the stages, you can only collect three of them, I think. But when I do this here, I'm going to get the gold armor with all four pieces in the last stage. So just going to get the base units here when I go through this walkthrough. And yeah, the upward dash, it's a lot more effective on paper. Alright, so there's the first sub-tank. We got an upward dash to get to that. Yeah, it's best to load this guy, let him stand down where the other guy just died, and just jump over him to get to the thing there, so that you can get over his missiles, which I did not successfully do right there. Typically when I'm recording, I have a push-to-talk with my space bar, but yeah, that doesn't really work when I'm trying to do action games here. So I also have a really weak microphone, which means there's a lot of static, and I apologize for that, but you know, it's just what I have. If you want me to have better stuff, you can always buy it for me. So the trick to this guy is speed, 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 speed. You have to stay in front of him at all times so that he's not charging you into the wall. But yeah, wall dash is a pretty common theme in the Mega Man X games. That laser will freeze you in place, so be sure not to get hit by it. All Alright, one boss down, seven to go. Alright, now you want to be careful this mud here because it will knock you down into those spikes or in place wherever it finds you. And now we have the second sub-tank. That's something I should note about this game. In other Mega Man games, you can grind for life pretty easily. In this one, it doesn't drop off of hardly anything. So filling those sub-tanks is a little hard. The only trick for doing that is taking the upper path in the crab stage and collecting those two pieces of life. But we will get to that later. So this boss right here has a cling to the ceiling mechanic if you're climbing the wall too much. So best thing to do is to let him start charging you and then climb the wall. And if you keep doing that, he'll charge at you. And you deal with that instead of him climbing on the ceiling. It's a lot easier to beat him this way. These things are a nightmare to deal with. Thank you. stuff way back there in case he decides to bomb them. Like that. This is another variation on the wall dash technique. You have to watch out for where he's actually dashing and where he's shooting at. See, yeah, he stopped right there, which means you gotta jump and dash back over that. But typically, yeah, he'll go back and forth. And yeah, see, there's the switch up. But yeah, you just gotta watch out for the switch up, but he'll typically just go back and forth. And fire this every now. And then, yeah, you gotta watch for the stutter step, too. Alright, and when he's flashing rainbow like that, he's invincible, so don't bother shooting things like that. There's that stutter step. Pop to his face, and he's done. So here's the intro to Bit and Byte, and yeah, that cutscene is not there in the Super Nintendo version, so it's not, you know, really obvious that Sigma's still the bad guy. And here we have the return of the mysterious Maverick, who looks an awful lot like Boba Fett, I mean Vile. So moving along, Bolt Catfish is the next in the boss weapon series. So yeah, from this point on, we're going to be using the weapon's classic style on the bosses as we defeat them. Yeah, this is going to be a lesson in how to take these guys down pretty quickly. Careful not to step on this platform, because that will take you down with a Vile fight. And, I don't know if you noticed those spikies there, but, those are one-hit insta-kills. And that's, one of the things I really like about the, X games especially, is that the more stuff you get, the more you collect as far as armor and hard upgrades and sub-tanks, the easier it is to play. Those one-hit insta-kill spikes are just super cheesy. Okay, yeah, they don't use them a whole lot in this game, I think. Alright, so these are all relatively easy to avoid. This one is sort of a little dashy thing to get the heart, and then you want to make sure you want to jump up fast so you don't get hit on those spikes. And yeah, just stay in the middle. Alright, so in all of the stages are little mid-boss points like this that don't have anything in them, and those are the random spawns for Bit and Byte. And I really should have done better research and figured out exactly how to tell where they are and how to change them and where they're going to show up, but I didn't. Yeah, I do manage to fight both of them here though, so you will get to see them. Alright, so the trick to this guy is to get him to be drilled right as he's available. Because when you hit him, you know, the first time he starts flashing and he's not available to be hit, and then boom, you always want to hit him as he's coming down, right there. And so yeah, it's just a matter of staying under him and keeping him stagger locked. So once he gets to about half-life, he'll jump to the middle of the screen here. Yeah, right here. So yeah, you just want to make sure you keep hitting him as soon as he's available to be hit, because as soon as that charge hits him, he becomes invincible. And yeah, as long as he keeps landing on the drills, you get a win. So next up is Crush Crawfish. And it's better if you can get the armor earlier in these games, and that includes charge upgrades and all of that. However, The problem is that the way the boss resistance works, especially in this game, tends to go against that path. So if you can manage to avoid getting the armor pieces, you can fight the boss with their weak weapons. And yeah, it can suck if you come across Bit and Byte too early before you're ready for them. They are tough bosses, especially Byte, the bigger one. He is especially brutal. Yeah, here's a great place to pick up a couple of lives if you get the tunnel rhino weapon. Yeah, there's some insta-kill spikes down there you'll want to avoid. So yeah, you'll see I don't have a lot of life here. I'm probably gonna die. Alright, yeah, this guy has three really nasty attacks. First one is that clappy thing. Second one is that claw thing. And then, yeah, those things hold you in place. But yeah, that's the one. That one is so brutal, takes so much life. Pick up the rhythm. It's just a matter of dashing over as soon as you possibly can, trying to avoid that claw thing. And yeah, don't get caught up in the clappy thing. Oh, so much damage. Alright. Escaped that one with the skin of my teeth. Alright, so this is where you start getting the good armor upgrades, even though you're on the path where you're beating the bosses with good weapons now. So in here is the arm cannon. And with the arm cannon comes the upgrade to charging the boss weapons that you get. And the gravity well and the gravity well and the volt catfish weapon both have things that you'll use to get other upgrades. Yeah, I think it's interesting to note that, okay, this game has two sets of capitals left by Dr. Light, and that's not counting all of the special ones. So, even if you don't count the special ones he left behind, that's 12. Then you add the special ones, the Hadouken, the Dragon Punch, the one for the gold, the four other individual gold pieces. And then there's all the ones in the later games. What did he do? Spend the last days of his life leaving capsules all over the world? It makes you wonder if somebody else wasn't leaving them there. You know, it was just his hologram that they were using to play it off like he's the one who did it. This boss you always want to catch on the opposite side of the screen he digs into. So if you just went into the top side, and shoot your super shot at the bottom side. All there, you know, he just happened to come up, so I caught him in time. But yeah, you'll see I go right back up to the top to shoot the weapon again. And yeah, he's pretty much toast right there. This is the start of pauses to charge, because it's important to have your charge shots available, but charging them up takes a pretty long time until you get the gold armor. So you just have to sit and wait. Patience, patience. This is the first boss bit, And the trick to him is to get him to dash at you from the other side of the screen while he's high enough above you so that you can duck under him. So yeah, I'm assuming you need to jump enough to make sure that he's dashing while he's above me. Yeah, the ice weapon isn't particularly accurate, so you want to make sure that you fire it at the wall so it's exploding for him to run into. Okay, and then you definitely want to make sure you beat him with the ice weapon so that he blows up but good. And I believe he is one of the requirements for the gold armor that we're going to get later on with all the four special pieces. So the crab blades here are kind of a funny boomerang style weapon. Yeah, you'll see me here, I'm trying to fight him like he's Sigma from X1. Trying to run that boss mechanic on him, whoops. So yeah, just wanna make him dash over. Okay, so because this is a remake from an optical disc, what you're hearing is an awful version of what was on the Nintendo, the Super Nintendo. The Super Nintendo had its own synthesizer built in, and the way this worked is that they would generate smaller, what's known as MIDI files, and these would have the tracks that the synthesizer would then recreate on its own, creating a much smaller file, and this is how all the old cartridge stuff kind of worked. And, yeah, so what they did with the optical stuff is they ran it through their own synthesizer, put it on the discs, and put it in the loops are kind of short, so you got a real long distinct pause as you're going through the level. Yeah, really poorly done on Capcom's end here. And this is me hoping I don't run into Byte. So, much like the catfish, the idea is to keep this guy stagger locked with the tiger ray weapon. But yeah, just as soon as he lands, start firing. Oop, dash over. seeing jumping on the platform, and that's to load the things above me into memory as soon as possible. So I don't get caught off guard. So the trick to this guy here is to shoot him at him as he's coming at you so that he jumps over you. And then this mode, it's just a matter of dashing over. I didn't do that. This is where I'm going to be liberating the first piece of right armor. Now, there are four right armors that you collect in the game. I don't manage to use them much. And this is me forgetting what way to go to get them. Go back there, buddy. There you go. Weapon. Back to the regular buster. And boom. First piece of right armor. So yeah. Once you get this thing, you can load one of the four right armors up on pads that are out. They're hidden throughout some of the stages. Yeah, don't let those fall on you. It's an instant kill. Yeah, don't fall into the pit either. That's an instant kill. probably should have been more thorough and showed you outside some of the things against the wall. I think those are spikes against the right wall there that are insta-kill. Okay, so this weapon that we use on the Hornet here is the gravity weapon, and the way it manifests itself is in this little sphere thing, and the trick to this is to stand right next to it so that it's coming right back into your body so that you can immediately fire another one just as fast as possible. And yeah, that's all it takes. Here's a bit of a supercharge show off. Just because I'm awesome. So now it's time to go around and collect all of the miscellaneous upgrades. First stop is for the helmet upgrade in Eternal Rhino. The helmet upgrade gives you a little map and a display on the main screen there that shows where all the items are. So this is the Bolt Catfish Triad Thunder Weapon charged up, and unless you hit the ground and knock down the boulder. This is the same technique used to get to the helmet upgrade. That was a painful double fail. Thank you.
So that little heads-up display thing here pops up whenever you enter a stage, and there'll be flashing red squares if there are any items available. So yeah, you can see the letters in white there with what's available. So gonna make a stop at Blizzard Buffalo for the heart tank here. And we see the flashing red square where we're gonna get it. Here's one of the only times I use right armor. That's just to bust up these perks here to get the right armor. Stage a little bit here just to check for Byte. Remember, like I said before, avoid that green platform right there. Oh, this is painful to watch. I know how horribly I did doing this the first time. So the trick to this is the gravity weapon charged up. And this is the best armor upgrade ever. This body armor It's just so necessary for reducing damage, and the game just becomes so much easier after you have it. Almost dashed into those spikes right there. Alright, so this is the only other time you'll see me use right armor. The idea is that the weight of the right armor collapses the platform that gets you to the sub tank. Alright, so you see the stuff that's in white is stuff that I've already picked up. This right here, actually, I did just as a test to see if the card would reset the video again. And, oh man, I lost like a 40-minute chunk and I was so pissed. But anyway, nothing new to pick up in there, so just an exit. And yeah, you'll see the pink stuff that's just question marks. Those are the extra armor upgrades, and yeah, I'm not gonna get any of those, so I can get the complete upgrade at the end. So yeah, nothing in that guy's stage, nothing in that guy's stage. Oh, gotta get the life tank and the gravity beetle here. And yeah, it's just right here at the beginning. What makes the boxes go away that block you from getting it the first time is defeating Last Hornet. So next stop here is the Crush Crawfish stage to get the last two items and to fight Vile. So yeah, this is the upper path I was talking about earlier. Didn't quite hit it right there, but there's a couple of pieces of life up there that are pretty good for grinding on. What you do is you get those pieces of life and just exit the stage and just grind that to fill your sub tanks. And this right here is a triad thunder to get to the floor. Another piece of ride armor that I don't use. Oh no, I'm about to use a piece of right armor right here. I think that's going to be the last time. Oh, and I did go up for the life. There we are. So yeah, when you want to grind life for your sub-tanks, you just get those two pieces and exit the stage. You just do that over and over and over until your sub-tanks are filled. There's four pieces of variety on there. There's like a falcon on the wing at the corner with drills and things on the fists. I just used the leg like this. And then the fourth right armor is an aquatic armor, which I never managed to use either. Need the right armor to punch through the wall, and that's the heart tank. So that's all of the pieces except for what's left in the Toxic Seahorse stage. So right now I've got all the upgrades possibly available to me, and I'm off to fight Byte.
Yeah, there's several ways to get to Vile. This is just the one for this stage. Yeah, you told me. I told you about the one bolt catfish to avoid. I think there's at least one or two more. Those are the probably most important ways. This one and the one in bolt catfish. Yeah, they'll all take you to the same stage here, where you fight Vile. Yeah, some nice little extra life pieces for your sub-tanks if you didn't have them already. No shame in using sub-tanks, folks. These games are brutal. Alright, so Vile has two forms here. He's in his ride armor for this first form, and the trick is to let him dash into you but not hit you, then jump over him. Like that. And that. It's working. And that. Yeah, just a two-charge on the weapon. Don't let it go up to the three. Simple, simple dash jump. Do it fast. And then this part right here is not real pretty, but yeah, just use the blades and attempt to hit him as best as possible. These boomerang weapons are just awful to try and use in practical purposes. And for using the blade weapon on him, he gets blown up for good, and this is what allows me to go on and get the saber from Zero later on. Alright, so this next part right here comes with a 50-second countdown clock, which is not a problem if you're, you know, doing it on a regular setup. A little bit problematic for me here. This is a good trick. You want to keep rapid firing as much as possible to start blasting these things before they shoot up. That saved you a bunch of time. Yeah. Stay on the elevator, stay on the path. These bricks that fall are a little hard to deal with first couple of times. But yeah, as long as you got enough time left on the clock, it's nothing you can't dash up the wall around. So yeah. With 6 seconds left on the clock, I escape the stage unharmed. Alright, so everything is cleared out. Last stop is Toxic Seahorse.
Sure to catch that life right there.
Alright, this is the last heart tank. And finally, here is the most gruesome of the twosome, Byte. He's got a really super staggery punch attack thing that he does it and launches you up in the air. And then that's a gravity thing that keeps you from jumping off the wall. So the trick is to jump off at just the right time before it, you know, hits you and dash over him. And it's really hard to do. Okay, you want to make sure you use the tunnel rhino weapon. That's the weapon that blows him up, and with both him and Bit destroyed, gets you the gold armor later on. So yeah, that's me being so super happy that I got them both defeated and on video that I charged up the drill weapon. So, to the right up there was the last platform that would have been useful for ride armor, except the armor that you want to use underwater is the one I'm about to pick up right here. Oh, and this is how to not use the ice weapon. Make sure that use a fully charged shot and that none of these other ones are on the screen, otherwise it won't manifest. So yeah, just jump on top of it as it floats up. He's too. There's some instant kill spikes right there that are easy to hit if you're not ready for them. Okay, and this is another simple dash and under. Fire the shot and keep dashing. So yeah, for those of you who aren't aware who Dr. Kane is, he's the guy who originally dug up Mega Man X here. Doesn't manage to say a whole lot about who he is or what he did, but I think this is the last game he actually shows up as alive. I think he shows up in future games, maybe only as flashbacks. But yeah, this is the last of him right here. Bye, good doctor. Okay, so in this video, I've run through these first couple of stages twice. This first time I run through to get the saber from Zero, and then I load it up again so that I can do the defeat these first couple of bosses here with the Z-saber. So this first time through is just sort of how to get to the Z-saber. But if you want, you can always use the passwords that are on the screen to get whatever upgrades that you've seen me get. Now the gold armor doesn't save, but the Z-saber does. So I'll let you know when the password's up on the screen, and you can use that to start the Sigma stages with the Z-saber and try and fight through them just like I did. But for right now, this is how to get the Z-saber legit. And yeah, while I was talking back there, I forgot to mention those spikes. Those are pretty hard to avoid. You want to make sure you stay as low as possible. And that part right there is just about being quick. Yeah, there's no finesse to this boss right here. Just shoot it. Blast him as fast as possible. Get that turbo controller out and just do it. Of course, I don't have a turbo controller, but I'm just mashing right here. Alright, yeah, he's gonna go scout ahead, as usual. Okay, so for the gold armor, you have to be at full health for the wall to let you through. The best way to do that is to get the right armor here. And I completely missed it there, so you're going to see me have to climb my way back up. But yeah, once inside the armor, you can collect life and be shielded so that any time that you hit, the hit counts against the right armor. And you yourself will stay at full health so that you can get through the wall. So yeah, top of here, dash over, that's into that guy. So yeah, you see him at full health, bust out one of the right armors. Hulk smash some stuff on the way down. And boom, drop it in the pit. Alright, so this is where the gold armor is. Now this is all four upgrade pieces, so there's an upgrade for the buster that lets you charge faster, and an upgrade for the thief that lets you dash twice as fast. There's an upgrade for the helmet that allows for multiple charge shots. But the best part, the absolute best part, is the body upgrade. You saw me get a tick of health right there, auto-magically. You'll see me use it a little more liberally later on. Yeah, all you have to do is stand still and you regain hit points. It'll fill your sub tanks, it'll fill your regular tanks. So if you're having a bad day and this stuff is just messing you up, all you gotta do is stand there. And you'll start regaining hit points.
so the reason you have to destroy Bit and Byte is because they are typically the boss over here. And having them destroyed alters the path of the stage so that who you're fighting right here is not Bit and Byte. It's this acid elephant tusk thing. And you want to be really careful that you're not destroying that trunk of his. Otherwise, he drops acid into the whole thing and makes the fight a lot more difficult. So yeah, you just want to try and drop drills on his head. Yeah, don't be afraid to use the sub tanks. And there he goes. Did you notice the slick transition there? I was hoping you wouldn't. Yeah, I had to pause the video and make sure that it was recording everything with getting biting the last boss. Oh. Yeah. This part right here where I get the Z-saber, I had to re-record. So this is the actual last part I was recording before making this video. I mentioned earlier this is something I had to re-record because video card does not like the way the game was changing the resolutions and frame rates and blah 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 blah. Yeah, this platform for right armor is not particularly useful when you got the double dash here. Because, yeah, you can double dash through the water, and you're almost all the way on the other side. And then once I get up there, which apparently was a challenge, just switch over to zero. With the controls, the way I have them set up, circle does that. R1
does it when you don't have circle mapped there. Alright, so get zero charged and knock out the two shots. And this one is just a matter of dashing under him. So that you can just jump off the wall, hit him there. And I tried to be finessy and hit him with another Z-saber, but Yeah, he was taking down my life kind of fast. And yeah, I just blast him at this next one. And this is me freaking out because the game got stuck in a little bit of a loop and I wasn't sure if it was going to give me the victory. So yeah, you beat this boss here with zero, and X is going to come in and get the Z-saber. Has a green charge, so he gets his first two shots are the regular upgrade shots. Boom! His Z-saber actually shoots out a bit, which is what makes it capable of being used on all the bosses. So yeah, this right here is a little just a bit of bonus footage. I'm gonna go back and do it again. But yeah, this Z-saber is awful fun to use on these bosses. Getting to this point is really brutal. You see a spot right up here where they make use of those instant kill spikes on the thing of platforms that go up the wall here. Yeah, these things are brutal when you're trying to learn them. So yeah, the trick is to jump up and let the stuff load above you. And then when you're jumping from side to side, the upwards dash helps change your momentum. And that helps with not hitting the spikes. This wall right here, the platform to the left is just a stop that you don't need to make as long as you stay on the right here. Yeah, jump up there. Now I'm ready to fight this other boss. How do I sit and let myself charge? I probably sit and let myself charge. Yeah, watch my health points go up right here. I think this is the first time you get to see it in this video, but it certainly will not be the last. I waste plenty of time doing it on my other run. I think I use it to fill up my sub tanks, and whenever I'm just taking a bunch of damage, because these games are hard. But yeah, the more you play through them, you know, like the X series and games like Metroid, the more armor upgrades you get, the easier it is, the more fun it is to play. Alright, and it's not like I needed to charge my HP anyway. This boss is ridiculously easy with the Z-saber. So yeah, hit him right there, dash under while you're charging, fire those shots, back on the wall, and money.
So this is the password right here. You use this password, you can start the Sigma stages with the Z-saber. And that's what I'm going to do right here. So you see I've got the game reset. I'll go to continue. Back out of this menu. Load it up. And you'll see that's the same password. Zero gives you the thumbs up. Alright, and as you can see, we're back at the beginning here. With no gold armor, but with the Z-saber. And again, I can't understate how easy it is to jump into these spikes. You just have to give it a little tap to get right under them. Or yeah, dashing over the pit is pretty effective if you can pull that off. And then this right here is just all speed, get up those walls. Okay, so without Zero to stop the ceiling, it's important to kill this guy rather quickly. Luckily, we've got the Z-saber, and that's gonna let us do that. Another part, dash over, hit that guy, get the little life pellet, bust out with the right armor, so that we can be at full health. Alright, so here comes about the most boring 2 minutes of the video. Empty sub tanks, just gonna sit there and let them charge. So while these are charging, I'd like to take a minute to talk about Capcom and how they've stopped making these Mega Man games. We had Mega Man Legends 3, had a playable demo. Almost ready to begin full-on production. Cancelled. Mega Man Universe. Game where we were going to sit around and make our own stages. Was set to be a lot of fun. Cancelled. There was a Mega Man Online. Only managed to get out in Korea. Never got much further than that. Maverick Hunter, a first-person shooter, or a third-person shooter. It was a shooter, and doesn't matter what it was, because it was canceled. Because, yeah, Capcom just doesn't care about blue people.
The guy who made the majority of the design decisions for in the Mega Man series got up at a gamers conference and said, "Hey, look, you know, Japan's losing the market. We need to innovate, or we're going to be out of the business altogether." And they pretty much told him he had to leave. And he's going on to make a game called Mighty Number 9, which should be out this September, they say. Looking forward to playing it. Really wish it was a Legends game, but I guess we'll have to wait on that one. Just a real shame. This whole series was very innovative, a lot of fun to play. And Capcom just basically, meh. Not only meh. They have been thumbing their nose at the fans, getting them into things like Smash Brothers and letting them cross over with Sonic the Hedgehog and the Archie comic books. They even did this fat box art Mega Man for Street Fighter versus Tekken, and that's just the biggest insult is the fat box art Mega Man. It's like, hey. We know you really like Mega Man. Here's the really bad version of him for the fighting game. And then, yeah, completely left him out of Marvel vs. Capcom 3. Just unexcusable. Unexcusable the way Capcom has treated this character. And all the Mega Man characters. Just inexcusable. Alright, so did I kill enough time? Have I charged my tanks yet? I think so. Not flashing on the screen. Come on, little buddy, it's time to go. Yep, check the tanks. Let's do it. I said let's do it. Move! There you go. Okay, so we're back at the acid elephant here. Now, what you typically want to do is be careful of the arm thingy here, because that will absorb your shots and grab you and do all kinds of nastiness. And what you also don't want to do is what I did right there, because then the stage fills up with acid and makes this whole process a lot more difficult. And yeah, the trick is you want to nail him right on top of the head with the Z-saber, and I only think I managed to do it once here. Because yeah, there it was blocked by the arm. I forgot that I died. Well, isn't that special? That should have been a hit. I don't know why it wasn't. Okay.
whiff. And there goes the trunk. Yeah, I do get a win here eventually, but this is not the most efficient way of doing it. So yeah, aside from the final Kaiser form of Sigma, that's the hardest boss to hit with the Z-saber. So the rest of this is going to look really impressive. Well, impressive except for the parts where everyone's blasting me right here. But you know what's really impressive? What's really super duper impressive? No matter how bad a day I'm having with these guys, no matter how much trouble they're giving me, no matter how much they just scraped me within an inch of my life, you know what I do? I just sit here. I sit here and my life regenerates. Now, how in the hell about that? Alright, so yeah, I'm gonna sit here, regenerate life, and I think regenerate that other tank, and move on about my business. But yeah, we get another lull in the action where we get to talk more about Capcom and how short-sighted they are, and how all they're making is Street Fighter 4 remakes, and I'm not quite sure where all they went wrong. I mean, they seem to have lost the ability to create new games, and all they're doing is re-releasing stuff. Oh, Wii U Virtual Console, PlayStation Virtual Console. I mean, they have not made a new Mega Man game in almost 5 years now. So, and I think they've lost the rights to this guy. Like, if I was them, I would just, you know, go to the guy who did all that designing and they made him quit and say, here, you know what, we're sorry, here's the rights, just start making them again so somebody's making them again. But they don't care. Capcom just does not care about blue people. Alright, my life should almost be regenerated here. Oh, nope, taking longer than I thought. Yep, there it is. Alright, and moving on. So yeah, we're back to the water part where the right armor is of no use. Here's a simple dash, and get around everything. Alright, so the trick with X is the same trick as it was with zero. Jumping across the wall, hitting him there, and money. Alright, so this is back to stuff you saw me doing the last time. This spikes part right. Yeah, the part coming up here with the vertical spikes, I messed up a lot. And I don't know if one of the mess ups is one of the ones I recorded. Sit here and regenerate life for a second. Not quite long enough for another diatribe, but suppose I could quickly talk about the Mega Man X command mission. Only one of those. Super fun RPG. Oh my gosh. Waited for one of those for so long. And you know how much my hands hurt after playing these Mega Man games? Playing an RPG, it's easier on the hands. And they only made one. Anyway, moving on. So again, the trick with these things is to keep jumping to load the stuff above you, and then to do the upwards dash when you're moving side to side so that it changes your momentum and you don't hit the spikes. Last place right here. You don't have to jump to on the left. You're just coming back to the right anyway. And this is the moment of truth. Did I fall down the shaft? Nope, I made it. Hooray! Saber technique for this guy is super simple. Just hit this wall to the right here, boom, dash under him, and we're charging up, fire the shots off right there, head back to the other side, and there you go. So what's the best part about Mega Man games? Boss rush mode. So in each of these capsules is all the bosses we've fought before. Now in this canister is some upgrades. And various things pop out when you shoot at it. But every time you hit it with the Z-saber, you get a life. And I get those lives and use them while fighting Sigma. Alright, so we're back at Blizzard Buffalo.
You guys already know about dashing over him from the first time. Well, the second time here, we got the Z-saber. And there went half his life bar. And that should have been the other half. But... Alright, so if you charge up the Z-saber, get those two shots off, and bam, hit the thing, life every time. Okay, so this guy moves from side to side, the idea is to keep under him. And then, yeah, there's a bit of a pause when he pulls that stinger out and dashes at you. So you want to make sure you wait till he starts dashing at you before you jump up the wall. And then, yeah, it's just a matter of not getting hit and hitting him with the Z-saber. So the catfish is a little tougher to avoid, but only a little. The big trouble is after you get him the first time, he goes into the zappy mode here. And you have to time this last hit on him just right. So yeah, while he's doing that stuff, you're kind of up in the corner, and then hit him with the Z-saber before the lightning hits him again. So yeah, this guy's firing off shots at you, doing a little bit of dashy. Oh yeah, jumping the putting the gravity well up there at low hit points. Yeah, I don't think you can hit him while he's invincible there, but yeah, still not overly difficult. And so here I'm going to be doing another pause to regain life. Let's see, I talked about the command mission. What else can I talk about? Rock Board. There is a Nintendo game that is sort of like Monopoly, where you're wandering around the board, you land on a space, and you can buy the space. And alternatively, you can buy the house on that space, and anybody can buy the house on that space. And then the rent is determined by whether or not you own the space, or if you own the space and the house, or if you just own the house, or the house can have a couple of levels, and the property value can go up and down based off of, you know, whether you own things adjacent to it. It's just got a real complex system that can really only be done with a computer. It's a board game. It's lots of fun to play. They never brought it over to America. There is a guy who did a translation, and you can patch the ROM and play it if you like. So yeah, this guy, pretty much same as before, just up and over, and then make sure you hit him with the Z-saber, like I didn't do there. And then, yeah, there went the invincible form. But otherwise, still perfectly killable. Yeah, this guy's just relentless with the grab attack. Oh, yeah, see, with the shield it takes a little less life, but it's painful to watch. And there you see me considering using a sub-tank. Just because I don't want to die on this guy, come on. Alright. So I hit him a couple of times with the saber. All right, so rock board, command missions. What else? I'm staring at the customizable card game here. Never managed to go much anywhere. That's a bit of fun. Suppose along with that would go the Battle Chip Challenge. It's based off of the EXE series, where you're just programming your Battle Chip turns and letting the characters fight it out. That's always more relaxing than trying to battle it out in action RPG style. But yeah, that's not to say that the XE series wasn't a lot of fun. They unfortunately went the route of Pokemon, where you had to have two versions to get all the battle chips and whatnot. But otherwise, it's okay. Lots of fun to play. We're almost back at full life. So who are we fighting here? The seahorse. Alright, so yeah, the trick is to just stay far away from him and keep going under. The point is to stay out of melee range. Alright, so I use the four or five of these lives that I get right here on Sigma. I edited it out, don't worry. You'll just see my best run. Alright, and yeah, this guy's got the block with his Wolverine claws that keeps you from damaging him. Otherwise, it's a pretty straightforward fight. So yeah, I think he does the block several times on me here. Yeah. Oh yeah.
so lame.
There he is.
Now a little rest before the fight with the Doppler here. Alright, so Doppler is the third hardest boss to hit with the Z-saber. He's got this life-regenerating field that you got to be careful not to hit, or make sure that you hit him soon enough so that the aftershock from your Z-saber isn't hitting him while he puts it up. You'll see it in a sec here. Alright, so kind of like Bit, you want to make sure up there's the energy regenerating field. So kind of like Bit, you want to make sure you're up in the air while he's dashing over so that he goes over top of you. And there's me remembering that you have to wait till he's all the way down before you hit him again. Alright, so wait till he comes down. Blast him. Come down, hit him again. Alright, so I did cut out my fail attempts here. This is the version where I do kill him, and that knocked about 12 minutes. Yeah, there's about 11-12 minutes of me messing up with this, trying to figure out the rhythm with the new HDMI and blah 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 blah. But what counts is that he's about to die right here. Oh, but first I have to let the sub tanks charge.
Alright, so sub-tanks are charging. What can I rant about next? We got Rockboard. We got Command Missions. Well, yeah, as long as we're sitting here. They did manage to make a remake for the PlayStation Portable, Mega Man Powered Up, where they completely did the first game from the regular Nintendo over again. And this game here could really use that treatment, especially with the way it comes in and out of resolution, and things just look so horrible when you try and cut and paste them together. Yeah, this series could use a lot of love that Capcom's just not giving it. Alright, anyway, back to the battle. Alright, so the trick that I found to this first form here is to make sure that you're on the wall, but you're facing him, so you're facing away from the wall. Take the hit so that you're flashing, and then do the Z-saber. Boom, there goes half his life. And then just stay up in the corner, dash as much as you can around and over all of that garbage, tap again, boom, he's gone with his first form. So the second form here is kind of tough. He's got this gigantic Kaiser body, and he can only be hit in the spot that's actually his original head. So it takes some careful aim and timing, especially if you want to hit it with the Z-saber. I should see some of my shots bounce off here. Yeah, that main shot hit his head for a little bit. And yeah, you see me going after the life meter. Just blast him down. Yeah, I missed so many of these shots with the Z-saber. Yeah, that just hit his body. That would have hit his head if that little mine hadn't hit me. And there I hit it from the backside. I think I hit the other one from the backside here too. Yep! There you are. How to collect all the items and beat all the bosses with the Z-saber. There's some quick jumping up the wall here, but more or less the game's over at this point. Really want to thank you for joining me. This is one of my favorite games in my favorite series. Yeah. Really sad they're not making more of these, but, you know, that's all on Crapcom. Yeah, Sigma is in the form of a virus. He will literally be everywhere until the end of time. All he has to do is make sure there's backup of him somewhere, unplugged, blah 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 blah, every time he comes back, and he could just be here forever. Forever. Alright, that being said, yeah. Actually, I can't say enough fuck you to Capcom. I mean, it's just, it's really short-sighted to kill a series this way. It just really is. I don't know. This is going to be the end of the narration. Hopefully at some point I will get a Super Nintendo copy of this and do a straight run all the way through with some better capture stuff. But this is just gonna have to be good enough for now. Thank you for joining me.